Welcome to Down to the River with Pastor Adam from Oglesby Union Church. Down to the River is a fast 5 minutes to drink in some of the living water given to us by Jesus through studying His Word, the Bible. From Oglesby Union Church, here's Pastor Adam.
Why do bad things happen to good people? Here is another huge question that brings up other questions, which is true of all the big questions of life. So let's dive in. Well, let's factor in that we live in a sinful world. We live in a world where people take advantage of others. We reside where people disregard the well-being of others for profit and prominence. So we are not all so good people to begin with. Well, then why does God allow all those injustices to happen? Why doesn't He step in and punish the wrong and reward the right? Doesn't He care about us? Well, the answer is yes. Let me tell you of an event in the life of His disciples. They're out in the boat in the middle of a great storm, and they find Jesus sleeping through it in the bow of the boat. They wake Him up and say, "We're drowning, don't you care?" Jesus gets up, questions their faith, and then silences the storm. But does God calm every storm? No. Just think of the freighter, the Edmund Fitzgerald, that went down on a cold November night. I'm sure there were plenty of calls out to God to wake up about the situation they were in. And we also cherish our will and our ability to choose, but where did we get that from? We got it from a God that we are questioning when He does what we don't want Him to do, or He does something that takes us through a storm in life. God has a will. One example from the Bible is, "For this is God's will, your sanctification, that you keep away from sexual immorality, that each of you knows how to control his own body in holiness and honor, not with lustful passions like the Gentiles who don't know God." Simply, we like God's will, but only when it lines up with our will. Life is easier and comfortable for us when it does. We also have a view of fairness from this earthly perspective, but God sees the situation from a whole different level. Does God have a better vantage point, even though we're scratching our heads with the outcome? And I think the hardest to accept or find some peace with are probably the physical ailments to children, or when a parent perishes, and there are little children left with no mom or dad, or some senseless injustice that eliminates the innocent. Why doesn't God step in? Maybe what we are asking is, why doesn't God step in every single time? Imagine if He did. This earth would essentially be what we paint heaven to be, but it isn't. This earth is living out the physical laws that God has put in place, but also reaping the sinful actions that we impose on it. Therefore, this community of earthlings feels the pain of physical disasters and our carnal actions. This is the reality that we live in, so we are really asking God to give us a miracle rather than just setting everything straight. Our world started with creation when everything was beautiful. Then sin made its appearance and mankind fell from obeying God and it wrecked everything. Pain and suffering entered the world because of our sin. Then God sent redemption. It wasn't a redemption for our physical conditions, but for our spiritual conditions. God sent His Son, Jesus Christ, to cancel the curse of sin for those who respond to His call. So we live in a world hindered by the fall of man, but also in a world that has received the offered redemption from God. God provided an answer for our spiritual condition and a provision for a future of another glory, heaven, where things will be all right, not for good moral people, but for redeemed, bowed before the cross of Christ people. We are all physical, therefore we all suffer here to some degree, some more than others. God may step in or not, but He did step in for what is more important than our physical, our spiritual. Is your spiritual life not suffering because it is surrendered to God who will provide a heaven where suffering doesn't reside? Join us this morning at Oglesby Union Church at 10:15 and check out our website at ouc.life. May you receive the blessings of God as you live your life to the glory of Him.
Join Pastor Adam this morning at Oglesby Union Church. They're right next to City Hall on Walnut Street, and their Sunday morning worship service starts at 10:15. Oglesby Union Church's mission is to know Jesus, grow in Him, go where He leads, and show His love. Drink more of the living water from Jesus today at Oglesby Union Church and go down to the river again next Sunday morning at 8:25 on Classic Hits 103.9 WLPL.